Hello friends, this is Sai Subhash. Today we are going to see some of the basic concepts in chapter vectors. Vector, mainly physical quantities are of two types, scalar and vector. Scalar, vector. Scalar means which has no direction, but magnitude is there. Magnitude means certain value, kg, length, if it is length means centimeter, like that. Whereas vector means both direction and magnitude is there. Direction is there, magnitude is there. Here, for example, mass, distance, speed, speed, etc. Here, for example, we can say displacement. Velocity. Etc. So in this chapter we are going to see only types of vectors and vectors. Vector means, once again, vector means which has both direction and magnitude, for example displacement, velocity, so on. Scalar means which has no direction but there is magnitude. Magnitude means certain value. Vector is denoted with a arrow. This is called tail and this is called head. Vector can be represented by, let us say a vector A. It can be, this is a vector A. It can be shown as A. On the top of A we can keep an arrow or bolt A, dark A. Whereas if you write like this, modulus of A or simply A, not bolt A, simply A, means this shows magnitude, not total vector. This shows only magnitude, magnitude of the vector. This shows total vector. Okay, let us see how many types of vectors are there. Vectors are of mainly 9 types. They are equal vectors, number 2 unequal vectors, number 3 parallel vectors, number 4 anti-parallel vectors, number 5 collinear vectors, next coplanar, next concurrent vectors, zero vector, last but not least one, unit vector. Equal vector means whose magnitude and direction both are equal. Let us see one example. One vector v1 is equals to 5 meter, mm. east direction, and another V2 is also 5 meter east. This is V1, 5 meter, and this is V2, 5 meter. Here both directions are same, east, and magnitude is also same. Magnitude means certain value. So these are equal vectors. Next, equal vectors completed. Unequal vectors, if any one of the magnitude or direction is not same, then they are said to be unequal vectors. Let us see one more example. We will change in this. If we change this V2 west, these are unequal vectors. Magnitude is same, but direction is not same. This is one type of case. Now we will see if directions are same, but magnitudes are not same. Northeast, V2, 3 meter northeast. This vector V1, 2 meter V1. This is V2. Here, in this case, direction is same, both are in northeastern direction, but magnitude is changing. Here 2 meter and here 3 meter, the magnitude is not same, so these are unequal vectors. Now let us go to parallel vectors. Parallel, let us understand this by one example. Parallel means simply, if two vectors are there, the angle in between them must be zero. Magnitude and direction must be in same, they both should be in same direction. Direction should be same. Magnitude here doesn't matter. Let us see one example. Vector V1 is equals to 5 meter. Simply we can show it like this. These are parallel, angle between them is 0. Both are in east direction, angle between them is 0. Magnitude doesn't matter. If you extend this up to here, they both will be same. So they are parallel vectors. In any case, these are parallel vectors, these are parallel vectors, but not these two. These two are not parallel to each other, parallel to these two. All these are parallel vectors. Anti-parallel vectors means theta in between them must be 180, and they must be in opposite direction. How here 180 is came, I will tell you later. Direction should be opposite. Magnitude doesn't matter. Let us say one example. There is a V1 vector like this, and another one like this, V2. Angle in between them is 180, theta is 180. They both are in opposite direction, because V1 is facing west side and V2 is going towards east side. They both are in opposite direction, and magnitude doesn't matter here. So they are anti-parallel vectors. Next, collinear vectors. If two vectors are in same line, then they are said to be collinear. Let us see one example. They both are collinear. They are on the same line. If you draw a line, imaginary line like this, they are on the same line. So they are said to be collinear. Now if I draw like this, means they are also collinear. If you shift like this, this become horizontal and they are also collinear. Next, coplanar. Coplanar means if two or more vectors are on the same plane, means they are said to be coplanar. Let us imagine this is a plane. These are two vectors. They are on the same plane, so they are said to be coplanar vectors. If I draw one more on the same, these three are coplanar vectors. Two planar, I will show you with one. Let us imagine this pen as vectors. This is plane. These two vectors can be on the same plane. But if we add third vector, it may or may not be on the same plane. Because if we keep like this, it will be. If we keep like this, it can't. Because these three are not on the same plane. Because then we can't say these are coplanar vectors. Two vectors always are in same plane, but three vectors may or may not be in the same plane. This is about coplanar. Concurrent. Concurrent vector means this talks about force. From a single point, n number of vectors starting is called concurrent vectors. This is called concurrent vectors. Zero vector means whose magnitude is zero. Direction is arbitrary. This is zero vector simply. This magnitude is zero, direction is arbitrary. This is called zero vector. Now, concurrent vector completed, zero vector completed. Last one, unit vector. Let us imagine these are two vectors v1, v2. In this unit vector helps us in to find the direction of any vector. Now differentiate it into one unit, single unit. This is unit vector. This part is called unit vector. After zooming it in, this is not a vector. Here this is not a vector. After this we can write it as, its magnitude is one unit, direction may be anything. Once again, this is called unit vector. Once again from starting, equal vectors means both direction and magnitude should be equal, then they are said to be equal vectors. Unequal vectors, if any one of the direction or magnitude is not equal, then they are said to be unequal vectors. Parallel vectors means the angle in between them must be zero and direction must be equal, magnitude doesn't matter. एंटी पैरेलल वेक्टर्स, एंटी पैरेलल वेक्टर्स मीन्स एंगल इन बिटवीन दे मस्ट बी 180 डिग्रीज एंड डायरेक्शन मस्ट बी ऑपोजिट टू ईच अदर एंड मैग्नीट्यूड डजेंट मैटर हियर. इन दिस बोथ केसेस मैग्नीट्यूड डजेंट मैटर. कोलिनियर, इफ टू वेक्टर्स, टू और एन नंबर ऑफ वेक्टर्स आर इन ए लाइन, देन दे आर सेट टू बी कोलिनियर. कोप्लेनर, इफ टू और थ्री वेक्टर्स आर इन सेम प्लेन, देन दे आर सेट टू बी कोप्लेनर. ऑलवेज टू वेक्टर्स मे लाई ऑन द सेम प्लेन. ऑलवेज टू वेक्टर्स आर ऑन द सेम प्लेन बट टू थ्री वेक्टर्स मे आर मे नॉट बी ऑन द सेम प्लेन. कॉन्करेंट वेक्टर, एन नंबर ऑफ वेक्टर्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द सेम पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड कॉन्करेंट वेक्टर. जीरो वेक्टर, जीरो वेक्टर मीन्स हूज मैग्नीट्यूड इज जीरो, डायरेक्शन इज ऑर्बिटरी, देन दे आर सेड टू बी जीरो वेक्टर. यूनिट वेक्टर, यूनिट वेक्टर मैग्नीट्यूड इज वन यूनिट, डायरेक्शन मे बी एनी डायरेक्शन, इट मे बी इन एनी डायरेक्शन. नाउ वी विल सी पैरेलल शिफ्ट. Parallel shift of vectors. Parallel shift of vectors. Let us imagine there is a vector A here. We can shift it into any direction for our convenience. But here angle should not change. Angle should not change. Angle. Should not change. Here angle should not change. Only can we shift to left or right means no. We can shift it. Let us take it here. We can draw here. 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 But angle should not change. Draw a horizontal line here. This and this must be same angle. Angle should not change. This is called parallel shifting of vectors. Now we will see how to find angle between two vectors. Here remember one thing, 0 greater than or equal to theta 180 degrees. That means angle between two vectors should not be more than 180 degrees, be less than 0 degrees. Let us see. And to find angle between two vectors, they should follow tail to tail rule or head head rule, head to head rule. These are compulsory. These three are compulsory. They must follow tail tail rule or head head rule. Here theta in between these vectors is 90 degrees. But suppose the question is given like this. Check, it is the following tail-tail rule? Yes, the tails are attached. So this is correct answer. But suppose if they give like this. It is not following tail-tail rule or head-to-head rule. So what we have to do here? We have to shift this vector or this vector here. We have, if we have to shift this vector, we will see. Now this total is 180 and this will be 60 degrees. If we shift this vector, we will see this total is 180 and this will be 60 degrees. Here, if we see head, if we remove this, we can see here head are attached. This is parallel shifted to here. Head, it is following head rule, so it is correct answer. If we have to shift this vector, this down one, this should be 60 degrees. This is totally 180. This is totally 180. Here it is following tail rule. So the rules are satisfied. So this is correct answer. Let us see one more. This is given 90 degrees. Let us say that this is V1, V2, VT, V3. Here the question is asked that find the angle between V1 and V3. So how to simplify this? V3 is here, V1 is here. How to get this to here? Now we can parallel shift V3. Here we have two vectors, so it is difficult to do parallel shifting. So if we do V3, if we do parallel shift of V3, it comes here and it will be easy. Let us simplify. This is vector V3. This is vector V1. This is vector V2. This is total is 90 degrees. 90 degrees. So here they asked that the difference, the angle in between V1 and V3. This is angle bisector. It divides the angle into two equal parts. So here the angle becomes 90 by 2. Half of 90, it is 45. So angle between V1 and V3 is 45. And angle between V3 and V2 is also 45. Because whole is 90. Like this we can find angle between two vectors. This angle is 60. This total angle is 300. Now we will see how to, which angle is correct, which angle we can take, either 300 degrees or 60 degrees. Here we already wrote that 0 degrees is greater, 0 degrees is less than or equal to theta is less than or equal to 180. That means it should not increase more than 180. Here it already increased. It is 300 is already more than 180. So this is wrong one. This is less than 180. So it is right one. It 60 is in between 0 and 180. So it is right one. 60 degrees we can take. Here 270 is more than 180, so this we can cancel. 90 is correct answer. 90 is in between 0 and 180, so 90 is correct answer. So in this video we have learnt that what is vector, how to represent a vector, types of vectors, parallel shifting of vectors, and how to find angle between two vectors. These are the some of the basic key points most of the students should learn in vector chapter of 11th standard. Thank you.